3 weeks, unbelievable, that we made world news because of a false flag and a person who's not dead. The only people that are dead are those officers who died in the helicopter because they had footage of the false flag and it would have given everything away. And so they were taken out. So what I'm gonna do is give you a little walking tour of this horror. I've lived here for 30 years and we are horrified that this put us on the world map and that George Soros paid all these people to come down here and do this. Now there's this memorial to somebody who's not even dead. I swear. If you go to my Twitter, you'll find out all kinds of postings that I did about this false flag. Jolia bags, which is a business that I started in 2010. There's even more stuff here than there was when I was here yesterday. Now somebody put up these music stands. There's nothing on them. I hope they get these dead flowers out of here pretty soon. I mean, there's almost too much written on here to show the whole thing. Because now it's on Google. I don't know why this mailbox is punk. That's weird. Oh man. So this thing over here is actually a no parking zone. And the truck was right there. You can see how narrow this street is. I mean, you had to be an excellent driver to be able to back up. Well, I hope these notifications aren't showing up on here. To back up as fast and as straight as that guy did, you had to be a super good driver. Now they have this road all blocked off. This is a cut-through road that we used to use all the time to get from one side of the downtown mall to another. Now we have to drive extra blocks all the way around the edge. But see how narrow this is here? There's all these bicycles over here. This archway over here was something that shows up in a lot of those videos. So this is an alleyway. I used to live a quarter of a mile from here, and I walked down here all the time. I was there for 2 years in a really nice big, a new apartment building called City Walk. And this was my downtown. This was my destination. I walked down here every day. There's coffee shops, there's outdoor cafes, there's life, there's people. It's a wonderful town. And now it has this horrible history of this event that happened here. But look how narrow this street is. And it's all closed off down there. So I'm trying to get this done this morning because it's going to start raining. Hurricane Harvey, the ends of it, is moving through here today. Here's that store that's gotten famous now, the Impeccable Pig. It's been here for years. I bought a bracelet in there a few years ago. So there's the rest of the street up to Market Street where the car backed up really fast. All blocked off now with a police car. So what I'd like to do is walk you over to the park so you can see how close it is. I'm gonna try not to get people in here. Sorry, I'm not real steady either. So there's a really neat gelato place right here.
Oh, goodness.
Dog bowl.
Are your feet okay?
Yeah, just have just a wet foot now. It's such a friendly town, they put bowls of water out for the dogs because there's so many people who come down here and walk their dogs. Wonderful outdoor cafes. There's a movie theater that was original to the town. And then it was in disrepair for a long time, and then there was a lot of fundraising and people brought it back together. The Paramount Theater. I saw Lily Tomlin there a couple years ago. She was really excited about being in Charlottesville. She thought it was a great town. So there's one street here, and then the library is up there, and then one block over is where the memorial is. Not the memorial, but the statue, the Lee Park statue. I am not going to call it Emancipation Park. It's ridiculous. Who's going to say, I'm going to meet you at Emancipation Park? No, you're going to say, I'm going to meet you at Lee Park. So this is coming on to Charlottesville Central because there's a beautiful fountain here. It's turned off right now. But on one of my periscopes, I was down here, and I have it when it's going. The city put up this sign so that people can come over and do pictures of themselves. Stand over here and talk about love. In some ways, it has brought us together more. But this is a nice little central area. I have been down here hundreds and hundreds of times. This is my hometown now. I've lived here for 30 years. So, I'm going to walk you over to Lee Park because it's right up this street here. This is how close everything is. There's actually a dedication here to the downtown wall. On their 25th anniversary. And that was in 2001. July 4th, 2001. That's how long ago 25 years anniversary was. So there's wonderful little cafes everywhere. It's Friday morning, early, somewhere between 9 and 10. So I wanted to get down here because it rained a little bit last night. You can see it's kind of cloudy. So there's only two places where you can get across the mall. There's, well, 4th Street that's closed now. And the other one I think is 2nd Street. And that's down by another theater. I want to make sure I don't trip on anything. So there's Lee Park. Right up there. So when I moved here from Washington, and I'd been up there for about 7 years, and I just needed to get into a nice, more of a small town community. So I came down here looking for a place to live that was nice, and I saw the downtown mall, and I fell in love with it immediately. And then I moved down practically a month later. So then my dad moved down here in 2009 when my mom passed, and then he just died last year. Today's his birthday. He would have been 93. I'll see if I can cross the street without anybody hitting me. But here's the stairs that shows up in all those videos of all those people being put together and all the violence and all the police forcing everybody down through here. Now they have this gigantic shroud on top of the statue. Absolutely disgusting that it's come to this. This is not a racially divided city. The blacks and the whites get along really well here. I mean, I could say some of my best friends are black, but that would just sound ridiculous. So anyway, they have taken down the plaque that used to be here. So if you go to my YouTube, no, my Twitter, on my Periscope, I have a really beautiful video that I did this summer